A Christmas Carol. In prose, being a ghost story of Christmas, commonly known as A Christmas Carol, is a novella by Charles Dickens. First published in 1843 and illustrated by John Leech, A Christmas Carol recounts the story of Ebenezer Scrooge, an elderly miser who is visited by the ghost of his former business partner Jacob Marley, and the spirits of Christmas past, present, and yet to come. After their visits, Scrooge awakens on Christmas morning a changed man, embodying the spirit of Christmas. Summary: the book is divided into 5 chapters, which Dickens titled staves. Stave 1. A Christmas Carol opens on a bleak, cold Christmas Eve in London. 7 years after the death of Ebenezer Scrooge's business partner, Jacob Marley, Scrooge, an aging miser, dislikes Christmas and refuses a dinner invitation from his nephew Fred, the son of Fan, Scrooge's dead sister. He turns away 2 men who seek a donation from him to provide food and heating for the poor, and only grudgingly allows his overworked, underpaid clerk, Bob Cratchit, Christmas Day off with pay to conform to the social custom. That night Scrooge is visited at home by Marley's ghost, who wanders the earth entwined by heavy chains and money boxes forged during a lifetime of greed and selfishness. Marley tells Scrooge that he has a single chance to avoid the same fate. He will be visited by 3 spirits and must listen or be accursed to carry much heavier chains of his own. Stave 2. The first spirit, the ghost of Christmas past, takes Scrooge to Christmas scenes of Scrooge's boyhood, reminding him of a time when he was more innocent. The scenes reveal Scrooge's lonely childhood at boarding school, his relationship with his beloved sister Fan, and a Christmas party hosted by his first employer, Mr. Fezziwig, who treated him like a son. Scrooge's neglected fiancée Belle is shown ending their relationship, as she realizes that he will never love her as much as he loves money. Finally, they visit a now married Belle with her large, happy family on the Christmas Eve that Marley died. Scrooge, upset by hearing Belle's description of the man that he has become, demands that the ghost remove them from the house. Stave 3. The second spirit, the ghost of Christmas present, takes Scrooge to a joyous market with people buying the makings of Christmas dinner and to celebrations of Christmas in a miner's cottage and in a lighthouse. Scrooge and the ghost also visit Fred's Christmas party. A major part of this stave is taken up with Bob Cratchit's family feast and introduces his youngest son, Tiny Tim, a happy boy who is seriously ill. The spirit informs Scrooge that Tiny Tim will die unless the course of events changes. Before disappearing, the spirit shows Scrooge 2 hideous, emaciated children named Ignorance and Want. He tells Scrooge to beware the former above all and mocks Scrooge's concern for their welfare. Stave 4. The third spirit, the ghost of Christmas yet to come, shows Scrooge a Christmas day in the future. The silent ghost reveals scenes involving the death of a disliked man whose funeral is attended by a local businessman only on condition that lunch is provided. His charwoman, laundress, and the local undertaker steal his possessions to sell to a fence. When he asks the spirit to show a single person who feels emotion over his death, he is only given the pleasure of a poor couple who rejoice that his death gives them more time to put their finances in order. When Scrooge asks to see tenderness connected with any death, the ghost shows him Bob Cratchit and his family mourning the death of Tiny Tim. The ghost then allows Scrooge to see a neglected grave, with a tombstone bearing Scrooge's name. Sobbing, Scrooge pledges to change his ways. Stave 5. Scrooge awakens on Christmas morning a changed man. He makes a large donation to the charity he rejected the previous day, anonymously sends a large turkey to the Cratchit home for Christmas dinner, and spends the afternoon with Fred's family. The following day he gives Cratchit an increase in pay, and begins to become a father figure to Tiny Tim. From then on Scrooge treats everyone with kindness, generosity and compassion, embodying the spirit of Christmas. End of the summary. Thank you.